I've been thinking about it also because cancer generally, I mean, by the time you're 40, let's say, I mean, we all have sort of precancerous little cells. But the question is, you know, do they grow? Do they then sort of metastasize or become a problem? Or do they just remain these little mutations that don't cause any particular harm, among other things, obviously? And for me, I become also interested. I'd love to get your opinion on metformin. Because there are people who'd say, well, you know, if you want to try to dodge that cancer bullet, we know that cancer cells are, they love kind of sustaining themselves anaerobically, or let me rephrase that, with glucose. Right? Yes. They love glucose. So yes. if we can dramatically lower, say, your, whether it's storage of glycogen, plasma, glucose, whatever it might be, then in theory, we should be able to lower the risk of cancer, and limit cancer growth, cancer cell growth. What are your thoughts on metformin?
Yeah,
and why are you taking it or not taking it?
I'm not taking it. So, and the reason I'm not taking it, I think, you know, that it has been shown, like you said, you know, it can possibly prophylactically prevent cancer so far. And I think the studies that have shown that have been pretty short term. My concern with metformin is the feedback mechanisms that happen when you're taking this drug. You know, how is that going to affect, you know, other, you know, cells and how they respond to glucose and things like that over the long term, like, you know, 15 years down the line. I think that limiting your sugar intake is probably, if you haven't damaged yourself so much by eating a bunch of crap, of processed sugars and, you know, carbohydrates and things like that, then you know, I think limiting your sugar intake is probably good enough, you know. And there's a certain component of cancer that's, you know, there is a genetic component that what I mean by that is not that you're born with it, but that you know, so downstream of, you know, a cell that's glycolytic, that's only using glucose to make ATP through this glycolysis pathway, is inflammation again. I come back to it because it's just downstream of everything. And inflammation damages DNA, and eventually you get it in the right gene that's saying, oh, this gene usually protects, whenever there's any damage, it kills a cell. It's called the tumor suppressor gene. You get it in that tumor suppressor gene, you're screwed. Now you're, anytime you get damaged, that pathway isn't like activated to go, whoa, wait a minute, this is not good, I'm gonna die. And it just keeps living.
Yeah.
If you look at, like, for example, our lymphocytes are glycolytic and they're not cancer.
Yeah.
So it's not as simple as, you know, a glycolytic cell is gonna give you cancer.
No.
But definitely, you know, starving, I think before you get to the point where you're starving a cancer cell, you can kill the damaged cell before it becomes to that point where it's become shifted its metabolism. So cells,
what do the lymphocytes do in like a ketotic state? Do they like derive?
I don't know.
Do they derive glucose from lactate or something?
Yes, they do get it from lactate. Lactate is something that they do use. Hmm. Yeah. And
cool.
It's interesting because lactate also is much like ketone bodies, energetic, thermodynamically favorable. Mm-hmm. So it takes less energy to make energy.
Yeah.
So you're consuming less oxygen because you don't need as many ATP molecules to make ATP. So